Hey y'all, my name's Jayna. As you can tell, I am very southern, and I wanted to do a little bit of some makeup tutorials. I am by no means an expert or accomplished or what. I think I'm accomplished for being an amateur. Anyway, I just wanted to share some of my ideas with you. Today, it's really cold and dreary and nasty out here, which is crazy that I feel so bad about it, because we literally was in a drought till up to 2 weeks ago, and all of our rivers and water reservoirs were empty, so we were having trouble with water, which is something we're usually not used to. We usually have a considerable amount of rain and not so much drought. Anyway, I saw this look on a YouTuber's page named KristianLeanne. I love her so much. I've been following her forever. And I hope she didn't mind me taking a little bit of a cue from her and doing a little bit. Not completely the same thing, but pretty close. So, without further ado, I'm going to start. A lot of YouTubers do their eyebrows and all that stuff later. Before they do their filming. But I thought I would go ahead and show you just absolutely every single thing that I do. And so I'm going to start. Oh, let me point out too, I have a mixture of expensive makeup and drugstore makeup. And you'll see that. If I can dupe something, I will do it, because I don't have the coin to be spending on expensive makeup if I can help it. So anyway, first start, I use this e.l.f. eyebrow kit. Anyway, and it's got a gel in it, and then it's got a powder. See, they've both been used a lot. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the gel. But by the way, I think this is for blonde, which is, or maybe light hair, which you can tell my hair ain't that way, but anyway. I was told one time by a Mary Kay lady, and she said, if you're not blackheaded, don't ever wear anything darker than blonde. So I've kind of held that, and here I am. So what I'm doing is I'm outlining my eyebrow with the gel. I'm just kind of pretty much making an eyebrow, or accentuating what's already there. After I do this, I'm going to blend it upward. I'm going to get the general shape. And remember always, eyebrows are supposed to be sisters and not twins. If you you definitely, especially when it comes to plucking or waxing, you'll get this, because you'll go crazy. You'll absolutely go crazy and wax or pluck everything. Okay, so I've got that one pretty much lined. You can see it looks crazy. Anyway. And so now I'm going to start blending upward into my actual lashes. Also on the inside corner that was heavy. And we just start blending in to make it show up. Really not trying to go for a heavy brow. I just like to have a defined brow as much as I can to accentuate my face. So, can you see it now? How it looks. Okay, so now I'm going to go to the second brow and do the same thing. Make a line right there. And then just pull. I'm drawing with a marker with the little brush that's given to you, by the way, with the lip kit. This lip kit, I tell you, has been wonderful. I mean, everybody talks about, you know, other, you know, expensive stuff, but I've had no trouble with this. I've in fact, it was the first thing I ever used, you know. There might be better stuff out there, but for me, I mean, if it works, then go with it. And it's inexpensive, so that's great for me. I don't have really a defined arch. I'm kind of more like what actual today's fashion is, which is kind of like the thick brow. And so Only put between my eyes, and sometimes if there's a stray hair. It's absolutely crazy. If you hear that snorting noise, or a growly type noise, just know that's my dog Yoshi, who's a pug. And he's okay, that's just the sound he makes. Yesterday I was trying to film and he kept knocking down my backdrop, so I've had to put up a barrier so that he can't do that anymore. Anyway, back to normal stuff. I'm going to use today as the Anastasia Beverly Hills eye gel. Now I got this in my Sephora play bag. So, box that comes once a month, love them. But anyway, but if you can't afford this, which I can't, but I'm using it because I have a sample of it, then maybe you could try out this e.l.f. Kind. And on one side, they've got it for your eyebrow, and then the other side for your eyelashes. And I don't know the purpose of having it for your eyelashes. I don't know, maybe it just thickens it up before you put your mascara on. But anyway, I have that. So, I'm going to start putting this. I'm going to go ahead and close my eyebrow gel kit and get my trusty mirror, which has butterflies on it, because my husband bought me a sticker book with butterflies to make me happy, because I was feeling down, and he's such a sweet husband, so I've decided to give it a really good place to put it where everybody would see it. So, I'm going up. I don't know if you can see the hairs. These hairs right here, you know, yeah, and I'm kind of pushing them down just the littlest bit at the top, and it, when I do this too, it also blends the makeup, so now I'm coming across, like I said, I'm bringing it up, almost straight up, and then at the very top where there's a little bit of hairs that want to go crazy, bring it back down. Okay. I feel like I don't have enough makeup over there. Okay. Alright. Now, let's see. What are we doing? Now, I'm going to start putting on primer. Something I'm forgetting to get together. Anyway, I'm using today the Smashbox Photo Finish, which everybody knows, everybody loves. Like, again, I have a small sample of it because of my Sephora Play Box. I'm going to get in trouble for saying Sephora Play Box so many times, but that's where it comes from. And so I'm going to put some on. I really like it. It's really weird, the texture. I mean, I'm sure all y'all probably viewed this by now. But it's got this light, velvety texture. It's actually quite soothing, but it's strange at the same time. You know, it's just a little bit off. I don't know how to explain it. But it's really velvety soft. Let me get that in real good. Okay, done that. And now I am going to go ahead and put primer on. Now, this is Urban Decay's Eyeshadow Primer Potion and Minor Sin. You see? Anyway, I've been using this for a long time, and I'm pretty much out of it. I don't think I can even get enough to do anything. So, today, I'm going to use the dupe for it, which is, I found, an e.l.f. Shadow Look Eyeline Primer. And it's in like a nude, neutral color. So I'm going to get my trusty mirror again. And I apply it to my entire eye so that it will be easier to, for the makeup to, blend well. And I immediately start to blend it out because it you know, will start to dry. So blend that out. Okay. And put it on the other eye. What is the first one? Okay, I'm going to blend it out. Yeah, I really love e.l.f. products. e.l.f. and NYX, both. They're just, they're the best things. And Milani, as you're going to see later on in this tutorial. I really enjoy Milani, and, you know, especially I enjoy the prices. You know, because, as I was saying, the Milani is great and inexpensive as well. So, I'm going to do something that I don't wear foundation. I wear concealer, I wear powder, I wear blush, I wear highlighter, I wear contour, but I do not wear foundation. My brain just totally popped right there. So anyway, but I do have this product that I got, once again, but I don't think I got this one from the box. I think I got it as a gift with some product that I had bought, but it's called Becca Backlight Priming Filter, and it's got a sheen to it, almost like a liquid, if you can see it, a liquid highlighter. And I love it. I mean, instead of, you know, in lieu of wearing foundation. And the reason why I think this is so cool is because of the lighting effects of it. It diffuses all the bad things in your face, all that show up. Kind of like foundation, but it's a trick. It's like a magic trick that it makes everything look better. Instead of, well, not instead of worse, but it just, it takes the tension off. I don't know if you can see it, how it's got a shine. See, it's got a little bit of shine, kind of a dewy look. And especially, like, if you're just wanting to go out, it's one of the better things to put on. It's just like, excuse me. It's, you know, something that you can just throw on and get going with. Okay. So, today, I'm going to do this look that I said I was going to do, inspired by KristianLeanne, a YouTuber, and pretty much we're going to do a basic smoky eye, and we're going to start, we've got our naked smoky, okay, and we're going to start with, I think it's smolder. I'm sorry, I'm going by my notes. No, it's combust. Okay, where's combust? Okay, there's combust. Natural color. Okay. So we do combust from the crease all the way up to almost to the very next to the, up to the brow, but not close to the eyebrow. I don't know if it makes that any sense. That. Okay. And then I'm supposed to take 13, which is this one right here, the little one. This little one. The light colored one. And put that underneath my eyebrow. Like so. That accentuates, of course, I'm sure everybody knows that, that accentuates your eyebrows, the highlighting of it. So, anyway. I'm sure everybody knows about this, but, you know, like I said, I'm just going through my routine and hoping, you know, I don't know, maybe you like me, maybe you pay attention to me, I don't know. So, anyway, after I do that, I'm going to go in with Combust. And, well, I'm going to blend it in, which I just did. And then I'm going to take, a pencil to my lash line. I think I'm supposed to be doing my brain. I have the words in front of my face, and I don't even know what I'm talking about. Anyway, I take the, I don't use the actual, Urban Decay 24. Hey, there's another dupe. So this is Revlon Black. And I'm supposed to line my eyes. But I'm sorry about these sounds. I don't know how to get this. Well, I do, but I've already started now. Get my computer to shut up. So this is just a regular black. It's actually designed to be smoky. Or be, not necessarily smoky, but to be smudged out. I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to put a little bit on the bottom, so I'm going to do that. Okay, now I'm going to do the other eye. And you don't have to be perfect with this because you're going to completely smudge this out, so it does not matter whatsoever, really. I mean, you want to try to have a semblance of a line, but it doesn't matter because you're going to smudge it out. You're going to smudge it out. It's a word. Just a little bit on the bottom. Lash line, just a little bit. Coming to my eye.
Okay.
Alright. Shoe away for now. And now, we're going to go to Smolder. Okay. Now, Smolder is our dark color. Wiping off my brush. Okay. Smolder is this color right here. Can you see it? Okay. So we're taking it and we're putting it on our crease and our mid. I'm wanting to blend it inward. You kind of want to keep the inner parts of the inner corner of your eye a blank space because you're going to do something else with that here in a minute. So, I just like to bring it up just a little bit. I'm going to put it on my eye. My eyelid. Yeah, I'm sticking it directly in my eye. Working on blending this in with a combust above it. Okay. And now, I'm going to do the other eye, but after we figure out what we're doing, we would use password, but we're not ready for that yet. Okay, so go ahead back into the Smolder and do your other eye, same way, kind of pulling in with it, rubbing into the crease. Like I said, you don't want to get too much makeup into the exact corner of your eye because you're going to be putting something else there. This eye is hooded, so I have to go butt up on it than normal. Blend it out. Everybody says you never can blend enough. I agree with this. Okay. Now I'm going to put it on my eyelid. Totally forgot that. I just remember too, I also forgot to bake my eyes. Well, this being my first time, there's going to be a lot of mistakes. So, hope y'all bear with me. Keep keep watching. But the fun part's going to happen. I know everybody's saying, so, yeah, this is done. But I swear, I'm fixing to do something really fun with it. So, I'm going to go ahead and take my finger and kind of blend this around, you know, to get it in nice and neat. That is going off at once. I'm getting emails for craft recipes for the holidays or whatever. That's funny. Okay, now that we got that going on, we're going to take. Black Market, and that's what I'm going to use is Black Market, and go into the crease. This is how I remember when I first got the smoky palette. I was like, this is how you do it without looking like a panda bear. So, so that's what we're doing. We're trying not to look like a panda bear. Although my favorite animal in captivity of all animals is the panda bear. And I wouldn't mind too much looking like one. Okay. That's one thing about using this dark colors. It seems to, you know, get in real quick. By the way, those are my dogs. That's Nella. She's a poodle. So, I think we're good on that darkening of that eye. Of this one. And I gotta go in with Black Market. Okay, well, you can tell I've ended up doing my eyeshadow done now. And I went ahead and off camera put my contour, my bronzer, my highlighter, and now I'm about to do the scary part, in my opinion. And I'm going to use these two as eyeliners. Yes, I know. It's crazy. Insane. Here we go. I'm going to get my brush. Let's see if we can do this. Like I said, this look was inspired by KristianLeanne. I totally want her to get credit for it. So I'm going to start with a darker one first. I need to see how this is going to work. Now, these are by Milani. The more metallics cream. Love them the most inexpensive and best lipsticks. So right now I'm going in with the purpley color. One's more purple than the other one. The other one's like definitely pink. It's like Barbie Dreamhouse pink. I'm kind of layer them. So I want this one to kind of come out a little bit further than the pink is going to. Now, me and cat eyes, that is a little bit of a problem. I don't have good cat eyes, so I do what I can. You can't even see me. I'm sorry. I'm just taking, this is a e.l.f. liner brush. So y'all can see the purple? Okay. Now, see, it already dries up. So, anyway, back to these. Like I said, these are the Moray Metallics. Can't see it. There we go. Okay. And this color is Automatic Touch. So, I'm going to take some more. Like I said, once again, this has not been necessarily approved for eyes. Which means you're not necessarily supposed to use it for your eyes. Because mainly it's because you can get allergic reaction, or it might have something in it that might actually hurt you. I'm taking a chance. I think that'll be okay. Like I said before, I'm going to go a little bit wider on this eye and on the other eye because I want to have the pink. And like I said, I stink at head eyes, so that's the best I can do. Anyway, let me put a little bit more over here because on my right eye because it doesn't look far enough to me for the look I'm wanting to do. I think everybody has to be super quiet once they start doing liquid liner. It's like, what's going on? It's like, nobody can do it. Can y'all see? That's like the purple. Okay. I'm sorry if I'm taking so long. I mean, I literally have never done this before. And I'm having to learn as I go. Here is the pink color. It's called the Amore Metallics Lip Cream by Milani. And this one's called Dramatic Diva. I actually got this one not because I will wear it. I mean, what happened was I was looking everywhere for these lipsticks. And I couldn't find them anywhere. And I found this one. And I was like, okay, I'm getting it anyway, whether I like it or not. So, that's what happened with this one. I'm not much of a Barbie pink kind of girl. I'm going to just try to do half as much than I did with the purple. I'm trying to give it some depth. That was the whole purpose in giving the purple first. You know, I was just thinking, but of course, like I said, hindsight's 2020. I could have just avoided the smoky eye altogether. But, here we go, here we are. And this is how it's come out. And it looks good, you know. It's great, but it's definitely not what I thought it would be. Okay. I'm just going to highlight the little cat's eye thingy I got going on. Yeah, the downfall, of course, with using liquid lipstick as eyeliner is it dries really fast. You've got to rush before it dries to get it done. Okay, now I'm starting in my left eye. hair and my eye is bugging me to death. Okay. What do y'all think? It's different. It's cool. Like I said, I was trying to go for a look. They were trying to combat this gloomy, rainy, cold. And I know some of the rest. I'm griping for no reason because we've been in a drought forever and we've needed it. And it's like, everybody's like, oh, we want fall. We want winter. Which in where we live, that doesn't happen quickly. Okay, so I did not do my mascara, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now, my favorite mascara of all time, this is Roller Lash by Benefit. Love it. What's so cool about it is that it curls your lashes. So what you do is you put it on, and you kind of wiggle it around like this. Wiggle it and pull. Now then you take your wand and you push your eyelashes backwards. I don't know if y'all can see that. I'm literally with the wand pushing my eyelashes backwards, holding them for a minute, and then letting them go. And like, huh? They stay in that position. We'll come back with some more, but okay. Now, I'm gonna do this side. Same way. Pull. Wiggle, pull, wiggle, pull. It sounds like a song from Barney. Anyway, wiggle and pull. Now, it's time to squish them down to curl them. Squish them down to curl them. Mm-hmm. Okay, now, I'm going to wait and let that dry. And I'm going to come back with, for my bottom lashes, they're real. And they're also by Benefit. Everything you see that's little like this, I got in my Sephora plate boxes, which I love. And I'm taking, it's got a little fuzzy tip on the end of it. I don't know if y'all can see that. And what's good about that is it gets really into the lashes. So if you have trouble with getting in your corner lashes, this is the thing to use. But right now, I'm going to use it for my bottom lashes. And I'm just going to kind of touch. Pull a little bit, but mainly just touching. Okay. Look at the other side. Touch and pull just a little bit. That's the thing too about that I like about the little wand is that you can kind of go across your nose and do that. Okay, that's done. I'm going to go back to the roller lash and thicken it up. I don't like to wear false eyelashes. I have, but regularly I just, it has to be really super big occasion for me to wear false eyelashes. Because I think if you get enough coats of mascara on your eyes, you're going to go good anyway. I've never wanted to do real thick, dramatic lashes anyway. Okay. Can you see how that's thicker? No. Okay. I'm going to go in to the other one. That hair, I swear, I'm about to die. Anyway. Okay, going into it. Mainly on the tips. To thicken up the tips. I don't know if y'all can see this hair, it's crazy. Okay. On the tips, to thicken up the tips. And then bend back a little bit more. Okay, well that's done. So, I didn't put any under eye concealer on, so that'll give you an idea of what I look like without concealer. So, now it's up to what I'm going to do for lipstick. Now, this one, or this one. I think I am going to go with the darker one and then put a touch on the middle. I really appreciate liquid lipstick. Just like me with cat eye, I really suck at lining lips. See? Anyway, that's the purpley one. Now we're going to put on the pinker one. I mean, I don't know why I can line my lips with the purple one so well. I was just noticing a fault. Okay. And I'm going to just put a couple dots. And that way, I got like a little bit of a highlight. So, you'll see it. So that's pretty much the finished product. And I'm going to take my headband off so y'all can see the glory of myself. As you can see, I'm kind of, in the purple top I'm wearing, it kind of has pink stripe through it. So, it really... it matches really good. So, anyway, thanks for watching. I know it's been slightly difficult, but it is my first time. So, I do appreciate you if you did watch. And if you could, give it a thumbs up if you think it was any good. And once again, I want to thank KristianLeanne, the YouTuber, for coming up with this pink liner thing. Thanks a lot, y'all, and I hope to be doing some of these every week. Thanks. Bye.